Today we will discuss about quality. Quality is a word which we use in day-to-day life. That is, if somebody is concerned with quality, or if some general public is there, customer is there, engineer is there, everybody talks about quality. So quality is a word which is concerning the life of every person in one way or the other. Before going into the discussion, take some examples. You take the example of four-wheeler. You know, the Swift Desire is a very good car produced by Maruti. When you talk about that, what is the quality of the Swift Desire car? The customers say it is very good. You also know that Mercedes-Benz is a car which also has a very good quality, and there is no opinion, no two opinion. Customer will immediately say, no, the quality of the car is very good. So in both of the vehicles you can say the quality is good. But you see that the quality of Maruti or Swift Desire and the Mercedes-Benz are having different meaning in their domain. Another example you take, that mobile is there, say a mobile of Motorola, again the quality is good, and a mobile, say a company MI, the cost of Motorola mobile is more in comparison to the MI phone, but the features and the applications and other functions are comparable or better in MI. So you can say the money which you have paid for this MI is just worth investing or worth expenditure. That is the value for money. Third example, you can say that if suppose you are purchasing an air conditioner, say the air conditioner is of Samsung company. You know, the service centers of Samsung are everywhere, even in small cities. But when you are going to purchase the air conditioner of O General company, then you won't be able to find service centers everywhere. So the issue of service is going to be there. So people will be deciding for the purchase of that AC on the basis of, maybe on the basis of the service center. One more example you can see, that if suppose you are having Apple iPhone or iPad, so possessing that that iPhone or iPad, it is going to be some sort of psychological advantage over others. This is another aspect of quality. So quality, when you say the quality, it has different meaning for different people. So you can define quality in many ways. These ways, first may be the conformance to specifications. That is, the product service meets targets and tolerances. The vehicle you have produced, it meets the specifications, it meets the targets, it meets the whatever dimensions or whatever the design parameters were, accordingly it has been manufactured. So it has conformance to specification. It says if the dimension of the seat is so much, it is going to be that much only. So whatever specifications have been spelled out, these are going to meet. So you can say this product conforms to the specifications. This is the one definition of quality. Another is the fitness for use. The product you have purchased, you know, when you are going to use this, it is going to serve its purpose. Like you are going to Delhi in a taxi, or you are going in your vehicle, you know the vehicle which you own, you will be able to reach to the destination very easily. It is not going to malfunction, or it is not going to break in the middle of the journey. So it is, you can say it is the fitness for use. Whatever purpose for this vehicle is, it is going to serve that purpose. Value for money means whatever money you are spending for purchasing that product, you are satisfied. You are able to see, or you see that whatever money you have paid, in return to that, you are getting more number of applications, more number of functions, and whatever you want, that is available in that product. Support services, that is the quality of support after sales. Few years back, there was no service station in Aligarh for Toyota company. So at that point of time, many customers didn't opt for purchasing the Toyota vehicle because of the support of the service center. Or the example which I have just given you, that when you are talking about air conditioners, the O General company may not be having their service centers in the small cities, so people may not be very enthusiastic about purchasing that AC because of the issues related to the service, etc. And ambience, prestige, friendly staff is the psychological, like you are having Levi's jeans. The name Levi's is there. You feel proud of that. Nike shoes. In many ways, you can define this quality. Maybe it is conformance to specifications, maybe fitness for use, value for money, support services, psychological, etc. So now, what you can say about this quality? Out of these many examples you see, you can say that you have to be close to the value, to the dimension, to the function for which the product has been intended. That is, quality is inversely proportional to variability. This is the modern definition of quality. Means, if it is close to the target value, if it is close to the dimension you have said that your product should conform to it, the variability is going to reduce. This is what inversely proportional to variability. That is, the product you are purchasing or the company which is making those product, these products are not varying much as far as the dimensions are concerned, as far as the working is concerned, as far as this other aspects are concerned. So you are going to reduce the variability of your product. So quality, you can say it is inversely proportional to variability. And when you are going to improve that quality, it means you want to reduce the variability. When you are going to reduce the variability, that it is going to the close to the value, the desired value, the target value, then you can say the quality of improvement is going to be there. And so you can say the quality improvement is the reduction of variability in the processes and products. Quality may be related to manufacturing or related to service, because you know that there are two types of industries. One is the manufacturing industry and another is the service industry. When you are going to talk about the quality related to manufacturing, it may be known as manufacturing quality. In the second case, it is the service quality for service organizations. So in the case of manufacturing quality, you can say this is the quality related to the tangible products. That is, you are focusing on the quality of the product which you are making, like it is conforming to the dimensions, what is the performance of that, you want to reduce the wastage, the cycle time for manufacturing. So all these aspects are going to increase the quality of your tangible products. While in the case of service organizations, you are making or you are having some sort of intangible products. That is, you are experiencing something. You may be experiencing the friendliness of the staff. You may be experiencing the behavior, the courtesy of the workers performing their task in that organization. You are being listened to immediately, promptly your work is being carried out. Waiting time is less. The organization, the service organization, is consistently providing that quality. So the service organizations are having different aspects related to quality, while manufacturing organizations having different quality. These are going to be the product related, and in the case of service quality, this is something your desire is going to be filled. That is the experience you are having with the employer, the experience with that organization. If it is good, you can say that the quality of that organization is good. Next is the cost of quality. What is the cost of quality? You see, this is the cost which is related to the efforts, the quality related efforts and the deficiencies. And suppose you are having some resources in your organizations, and these resources are going to be used in maintaining and improving the product quality. That is, you want your product should be good, or you want to improve your product. The quality of the product is going to be improved. So whatever resources you are utilizing, when you are comparing those resources which have been utilized for maintaining and for improving product quality with the failure, that is when you are comparing the expenditure incurred on product failure, when you are comparing the two, this methodology which is going to determine the cost is known as cost of quality. So in this case, what are you doing? You are going to find out the amount or the resources used for maintaining and improving the product quality, and when you are comparing this with the expenditure being incurred on the product failure. This cost of quality is of different types. These may be prevention costs, appraisal costs, internal failure costs, and external failure cost. Broadly, we can say that in four categories we can divide this cost of quality. As just said, prevention cost, appraisal cost, and internal failure cost, along with the external failure cost. Let us see one by one what these mean. The prevention cost. This is what it is related to. You are utilizing your resources, you are investing something, you are investing your money in keeping the failures or the defects at the minimum level. That is the prevention cost. You want to prevent the failure of your product. So when you want to prevent the failure of your product, you need to invest money. You need to have some cost to be incurred in keeping failure at minimum. So for prevention, what are required? That the specification on the basis of which you are having your product, the product should conform to the specifications. Your worker should be properly trained so that no rework, etc. is going to be there. Product development, that is the design of the product, should be proper, otherwise there may be the chances of failure. Or when you are going to have some prevention costs, you are going to develop quality control systems, again some cost is involved in that. So in the case of prevention cost, every cost which you are going to have in the plant, in the organization, that is for making the product to conform to the specifications, for providing training, proper product development, and other systems related to the quality control, these are going to be considered under prevention cost. Appraisal cost, or you can say assessment cost, it is what when you are keeping the quality at satisfactory level, that is you are assessing the quality of the product. So in this, you are going to find out what is the quality of the material, that is the material control is going to be there. You are testing that, you are evaluating, and inspection is being carried out of your product. That is, what is the quality of your product, what type of supplier it is, whether supplier is able to supply the proper material, etc. So you are assessing each and every aspect related to quality. Then that cost, whatever cost which is going to incur in the assessment of that, this is known as the appraisal cost, internal failure cost. These are the costs which are going to incur in rework, material wastage, machine breakdown, etc. if the product is found defective before reaching to end user. That is, when your product is in the organization itself, in the plant itself, it has not gone to the end user, and before that you are going to see the quality of that. And if it is some sort, you can say it is not matching the quality standard, then you are required to go for rework. In that case, some material wastage is going to be there, or it is the product performance is not proper or not as per the quality standard due to machine breakdown, etc. These are the costs which are internal failure costs. In the case of external failure cost, these are the costs when the product has gone to the customer. That is, when you have sold your product to the customer, then if suppose some complaint is going to be there, so you need to address that complaint. The cost involved in that, that is coming under this external failure cost. Maybe some warranty claims are there, again cost is going to incur in that. Returning rejected products, improper packaging, or you have seen this several times that some vehicle has recalled its product to change some specific component there. So whatever costs are involved, these are going to be there as external failure costs. Cost of quality is going to have a very, very important aspect. That is, different costs are when you are going to add all these costs, these are going to be of significant amount, which may result in the quality cost. We have to see that these costs should be as minimum as possible. Different types of quality grows, you can say that many researchers have carried out tasks in the field of quality. Some of these are Shewhart. He gave the process variability, that is the variability in the process should be minimum. Gave the concept of statistical control charts, that is the variation in the product should be on the basis of the random causes, because random causes are there, you cannot eliminate them, but assignable causes can be eliminated. So with the help of this statistical control chart, you can find out that whether the process is under control or not. Edward Deming's have given 14 points to quality improvement. These 14 points are: create a constancy of purpose focused on the improvement of products and services. Second is, adopt a new philosophy that recognizes we are in a different economic era. Third is, do not rely on mass inspection to control quality. Fourth is, do not award business to suppliers on the basis of price only, but also consider quality. Fifth is, focus on continuous improvement. Sixth is, practice modern training methods and invest in on-job training for all employees. Training is important here. Next is, improve leadership and practice modern supervisory methods. Next is, drive out fears. Break down the barriers between functional areas of business. Eliminate targets, slogans and numerical goals for the workforce. Next, eliminate numerical quotas and work standards. Another one is, remove the barriers that discourage employees from doing their jobs. 13th is, institute an ongoing program of education for all employees. And the final is, create a structure in top management that will vigorously advocate the first 13 points. That is, not only these 13 points are to be seen, but these are to be monitored as well, that whether we are employing this properly or not. So Edward Deming's, these 14 points were being taken in toto, and were being considered by different organizations to improve the quality. Joseph Juran was there, that is, he said that quality as a fitness for use, and gave the concept of cost of quality. Pinbaum gave the concept of total quality control, that is, everybody associated with the business, with the organization, is have some say in the quality improvement, or he needs to be involved in improving the quality. Crosby, concept of zero defect, that is, he said the defects in the product should be eliminated. Ishikawa gave cause and effect diagram, which is known as Ishikawa diagram or fishbone diagram, and he gave the concept of internal customer. Internal customer is the employees, the stakeholders, or the person who is the retailer. These are our internal customers there. And Taguchi also gave the loss function, that is, what is there, if the product is there and it is not conforming to the standard, it is going to have some loss to the society. So these are some of the grooves related to the quality which have given their contribution towards improving this quality. Total quality management, as the name indicates, you have to manage the total quality, you have to manage the quality in total, and that is, everyone associated in the organization is contributing towards managing the quality. What is going to be there? You are going to involve whole of the business. When you are involving whole of the organization, there is sense of belonging is there, there is sense of accountability is there, there is sense of appreciation is there, there is, people are going to think that it is their company and they need to give their contribution so that the product is going to have value or to have quality. When everybody is involved in that, it is the chances are there that you can identify root cause of quality problems, that is, at what stage, at what level, at which point the quality is going to suffer, and where is the problem which is going to give the quality related issues. You have to make your product user centric, because it is the user only which is going to give you the quality related scenario, that is, unless and until the customer is satisfied, you are not going to able, or you are not going to survive in the market. So continuous improvement is going to be there. It is not the case that today you have carried out some improvement in the process and it is going to last long or last continuously till the product is going to be manufactured. You have to keep doing the improvement, or you have to keep taking a step towards the improvement of that quality. Employee empowerment is there, because employee knows that he is also associated with this product, he is also contributing in the organization, the organization is also dependent on him as far as the quality product is concerned, or the product manufacturing is concerned. That employee empowerment is going to be there. And supplier quality management, this is also important, that the supplier should be of having proper credibility. He should be able to supply a standard material, and whatever he is going to supply, the management should be able to ensure that it is not going to affect in a negative way as far as the product is concerned. This is what related to the introduction of the quality, that is, what the quality is, in what way you can define this quality, what actually mean this quality. In the nutshell, we can say we have to be very, very close to the target value, we have to be very close to the value for which we have made this product, and when you are going to reduce this variability, your quality is going to improve. So you can say that the definition of the quality may be, you are going to reduce the variability, or the quality is inversely proportional to the variability.